40th birthday. I woke up in Poland, just accidentally. I looked around and thought I better keep on rolling. So we rolled right the fuck on out of Poland, alright. Hey! Free Christiania, that's where my birthday ended. My friend said, where were you? We couldn't find you. Why you bleeding? So I said, as I bled, I've been swinging a chicken. I've been swinging a chicken. Superman's a Jew, or at least an immigrant, and Nosferatu too. But what do they do when they screw up so bad? It's like a kryptonite magnet that is dragging them to their deathbed. What do they do instead? They say, if you need me, I'll be swinging a chicken. Between committing a sin and just committing another sin, now then you want a shot at redemption. You want a shot at redemption. Don't use a rubber chicken, 'cause then the sin just bounces back in. Now you take it by each. Times. I was raised a Jew. Actually, I remain one too. There's many reasons, they are not few. I'll tell my favorite one to you. It's not what you think, it's what you do. So what does that mean? Anytime I've lost a battle and I'm feeling low, there's an emotional place that I can go. Does my God judge me for going there? No. I'll tell you what it is and I'll start real slow. Let's dance and got it, and then you feel great when there's people killing children in my name, and my guts are churning with the horror and the shame. Well, it helps me to contemplate. So let's dance and celebrate. For instance, old Joe Stalin for some reason thought there was some kind of Jewish doctor's plot. So he had some of them exiled and the rest of them shot. He wanted no Jewish doctors, and that's exactly what he got. All right. And now, here is the part where we come to the joke. That's when he had a massive stroke. People said, "What's wrong, Joe?" But he never spoke. A brain specialist might have helped him, but he'd gone up in smoke. Let's dance and celebrate the misfortunes of people we hate. It feels odd at first, but wait. Once you get it, you got it, and then you feel great. Oh, Schadenfreude needs no translation, so I guess I'll take it as a reparation. I'll take it out on a date. We'll dance and celebrate. Take it away. Is acting all detached, and it feels like there's nowhere to reattach her. It soothes me to reflect upon the pathetic decline of Margaret Thatcher. Ariel Sharon, Ariel Sharon, his death lingered on and on. Ariel Sharon, Ariel Sharon, his death lingered on and on and on and on and on and on and on. And supermalifragilisticexpialidocious, I hope that Stephen Harper dies of muscular sclerosis in a Northern Ontario First Nations reservation health center, or just a ditch. Let's dance and celebrate the misfortunes of people we hate. It feels a bit funny at first, but wait. Once you get it, you got it, and then you feel great. Oh, bad things happen to good people, it's true, but at least they also happen to assholes too. And sometimes that's all there is to consolate. So let's dance and
missionaries in heaven eat at Schwartz's and fuck all night. And when Dee Dee gets a donkey, everything will be alright. When Dee Dee gets a donkey, everything will be alright. When Dee Dee gets a donkey, everything will be alright. Get down, okay, making everything alright. Everything alright. Oh yeah! Donkey will protect the chickens from the predators of this land. The donkey's hand, the donkey will kick and bray. Oh, the donkey will kick and bray. The donkey will kick and bray, and the children will evolve into donkey human creatures full of intelligence and love. Humanity shall awaken from its long idiotic night, because when Dee Dee gets a donkey, everything will be alright. When Dee Dee gets a donkey, everything will be alright. When Dee Dee gets a donkey, everything will be alright. The cutie, luxuriate in the terror of the violin's risky beauty. And when it's time to pass the hat at the end of the night, remember when Dee Dee gets a donkey, everything will be alright. When Dee Dee gets a donkey, everything will be alright. When Dee Dee gets a donkey, everything will be alright. The donkey.
My city has been in a housing crisis for 15 years or more. Middle class families can't afford to live here, and there's a $10,000 fine for being poor. Well, they said if we let them build all these condo towers, the market would pull down the rent. Now we've got the most expensive city on the whole damn continent. Our mayor says he wants something called eco-density. And of course, it's a sin not to be green. But when Mayor Happy Planet says eco-density, what does he really mean? He means Sunday condos, Monday condos, Tuesday Wednesday condos, Thursday, Friday, a few more condos, Saturday, for a change, condos. What happened to 1,000 culture buildings and counting? Well, they knocked them down to build some condos, and the social housing on Little Mountain 'cause we need more condos. All the rich bitches, capital, that's a special kind of condos, the kind of condos that you call after the thing that you knocked down to make the Sunday condos. Monday condos, Tuesday, Wednesday condos, Thursday, Friday, a few more condos, Saturday for a change, townhouse condominiums. What is the plan for the Georgia Viaduct? Well, they're gonna knock it down and build some condos. Why's the city $400 million on the hook? They're fucked. They paid some guys to build Olympic condos. And what about the sacred burial site? Not as sacred as condos, until the Musqueam Nation actually put up a fight, and that's how you stop the condos. So what's gonna happen now, for God's sake? Are we just gonna let them build more condos, or could this be the time when we finally put the brakes on Vancouver's mad sickness for Sunday condos, Monday condos, Tuesday, Wednesday condos, Thursday, Friday, a few more condos, Saturday for a change. Market artists, live work studios.
Thank you.
Coffin Bay. 10 Kilometer und die rote Licht. Ständig guck ich links und rechts. Aber ich kach so mit der Wein und der Servomaschine. Ich kach so mit der Wein und der Servomaschine. Hab's da guck, wenn hab mein Fuß gedrückt bis in dir. Geh von der Ruhm und Ruhm dem Hotel Garage. Der Greg, der Chef 94, aber ich kann so mit ein in der Servomaschine. Just because you think you smell something funny on their breath. But these new friends, they are a special kind. They used to say that we pollute their blood and worse. You know they used to kinda hate us until they changed their minds. They suspected that we were more skillful lovers, true of course. But now they march around their rallies with Star of David in their hand. They don't even throw it in a bonfire at the end. I suppose we should be grateful now they hate some people more. I was raised to be polite, so I said thank you, nationalist scumbags, for your support. I said thank you, thank you, thank you. But no thank you, no thank you. And then there are those Christians born again. You know they used to call us Christ killers, but now the sons of Sheriff Clark were on the road to Washington when they converted Israel to their sacred cow. But it's all just to serve that comic book of prophecy. You see, for Jesus to return, it is imperative that we be the center of a war that will destroy the world entire. Then they'll laugh and dance and sing as we fall with the 6 million to
their lake of fire singing, thank you, thank you, thank you. But no thank you, no thank you, no thank you, no thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. To a party, you look around and think I feel so wrong here, and then you whisper to your soul, oh soul, where are we, and why do all these assholes act like we belong here with them? And you think about what your mom said about the company you keep. You are lingering by the cheese dip, so depressed you wanna weep. Maybe that's the time when it is time to contemplate why we're getting so much love from all these people more famous for their ability incinerate and say, thank you, Madame Le Pen, thank you, UKIP, thank you, good builders. But no, thank you, thank you, no, thank you, thank you, thank you, Mr. Blocker, thank you, CBN, thank you, Mr. Breivik. But no, thank you, no, thank you, no, thank you, no, thank you, thank you, Stephen Harper, thank you, Sarah Palin. Netanyahu, but no thank you, no thank you, no thank you, no thank you, 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 thank you,
thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, Christians irritate us with their Christmasness. It seems like every year. And then the pagans must remind us they invented this. Okay, we get it, it's clear. Jewish children saw the others open presents. It made them sad and blue. Their parents found a minor Jewish holiday so they could open presents too. It's a tokenistic cultural compromise that depresses me with a sigh. But the little ones seem to like it, so I guess that that is why. I'm ambivalent about Hanukkah when Hanukkah comes around. The feeling's not acute, it's a chronic of a thinking that is probably unsound. Unsound! Well, I don't mean to ruin your party. I'm sorry if I'm bringing you down, down, down. But I'm ambivalent about Hanukkah when Hanukkah comes to town. Well, do you know the story of Hanukkah? I wonder, have you ever known? Well, the Jews resisted Greek civilization till the Greeks just got tired and went home.
I'm out of here, guys.
A tradition of religious independence, which we pass to the fruit of our loins, or a festival of violent fanatics, punctuated by chocolate coins. Like the glory of God's creation at the start of a brand new day. Sometimes I could just take it or leave it, and that is why I say, hey, I'm ambivalent about Hanukkah. Hanukkah comes around, I reach for a great gin and tonic, thinking that it's probably on sale. On sale! It's not the shallow dismissal of the atheist, it's more spiritual and profound. But I'm ambivalent about Hanukkah. Hanukkah comes to town, you know I mean it. Well, I'm ambivalent, it's not an equivalent, I know it's irrelevant, but oh well, what the who believes, but still I shake my fist at the sky. Why couldn't the Lord have worked a little bit harder, made me a little bit smarter, made just a little less murder? But I don't feel so mad at God when I see you in your summer dress. Not so mad at God when I see you in your summer dress. Dress. out on our way to Bremen. That's where we're going to be musicians. People say we're too used up to be allowed to live, but we still got a caravan of fucks to give. So we're on our way. We'll speak of death another day. With what we stole from the thieves. The donkey does our fearless leading. Realism is something he's not needing. People talk like they understand the world, but they may find when he kicks them in the head, it's liable to change their mind. And so we're on our way. We'll speak of death another day and have a sacred feast with what we stole from the thieves. Thinks he can predict the future. Actually, he's just a rooster. If he could read his own entrails, he would see the comfort-giving chicken soup that is his destiny. So we're on our way. We'll speak of death another day and have a sacred feast we stole from the thieves. Dog is full of moral confusion, but the cat lives under no illusion. The dog did his killing out of loyalty and for pay, but the cat knows why he would have done it anyway. So we're on our way. We'll speak of death another day and have a sacred feast with what we stole from the thieves. We're on our way. We'll get there any day now and have a sacred feast with what we stole from the thieves. Thank you. are on our way to Bremen. That's where we're going to be musicians. They're gonna build a statue of us in the square to commemorate the fact that we were never there.